China Dao Tu Zhu Chu Ren, Ming Mei. Hi everyone, and welcome to the first edition of China It Out. It's like trying it out, but I'm in China, so it's China It Out. I'm your host, Rachel Deason. Throughout this video series, I will be your guide to explore authentic Chinese culture and learn Mandarin Chinese. Today I'm here at Xiaofeiyang Huobo. Xiaofeiyang Huobo is a Sichuanese hotpot restaurant. So today, we're going to go through the process of how to order hotpot, how to get the sauces for hotpot, how to eat hotpot. Normally, hotpot is a very communal event. I would come here with 5 or 10 friends, but today you're going to be watching me eat solo. Basically, you're just going to be watching me stuffing my face until I can't walk out of here. Luckily, I brought my friend Jing along to help me eat, and also to give me some pointers about what kinds of categories of food I need to eat. Jing is the editor-in-chief of Dig Mandarin and a Chinese teacher, so she will help me through this process, and I will help you through the process. So it's a collaborative event. We are all in this together. All right, let's go. Specialty foods and their packages. I'm not going to be focusing on this so much today because there is all of this. The first step is choosing our huodi or hotpot base. There are three categories of hotpot base. There is a bai huo, hong huo, and yuan yang huo. Bai huo is a clean kind of white broth, not spicy. That's what I prefer. Now, hong guo literally means red pot, and that's going to be where the spice comes in. Like I said, this is a Sichuanese food, so they really, really bring the spice. And then yuan yang guo literally means a happily married couple in a pot, and that's one side bai guo and one side hong guo. That's what I'm going to order today, because Jing prefers the spicy, and I prefer the not spicy. To me, the spicy broth just makes everything taste the same, and I would prefer the foods to kind of speak for themselves and let the sauces do the work. Alright, so, after the guodi, I'm going to look at the different types of foods we have. So we have rou lei. Is just meat, okay? Rou means meat. And they've got lamb, yang rou. They have beef, niu rou. And they have an other category, which is maybe some pork, and then they also have meatballs, okay? After the rou lei, we have our zha xiang. Zha xiang means miscellaneous. It's just anything that doesn't fit into a category. This is kind of where the fun stuff comes in. Like I said though, I'm kind of a picky eater, and so normally I might avoid this section, but for you today, I will order some of this. So let's see, they have a pig's brain, I might have to order that one. There's duck blood, there is little sparrow's eggs, just all kinds of miscellaneous foods. Then we have our haixian. Haixian means seafood. We also have kuxian, not seafood, but river fish and river seafood. That doesn't really work. Anyways, skipping that one, going on to junlei. Junlei is mushrooms, and I didn't know there were so many kinds of mushrooms until coming to China, and they're all very, very different. I am just kind of going to order the one that is the easiest. Alright, then we have our doujipin. Doujipin is our tofu category. I also didn't know there were so many kinds of tofu before coming to China. Then we have our shucai. Shucai is vegetables. Here at the bottom of the menu, you can see, is a section of non-hotpot foods. They have shaokao, which is like kebabs, but I'm not gonna order those today because I'm already eating way too much. Then we have our 主食. 主食 is our main staple food. They have pretty much everything that you would like. They've got noodles, they have rice, they have these pumpkin cakes, which are delicious. It's like a pumpkin-y rice kind of little cake. They have spring rolls, other kinds of cakes. That is really going to be delicious. And then we have our 饮料. 饮料 is beverage, drink. Now, hot pot, especially the 红锅, the spicy kind, is a kind of 上火. 上火 means to raise your internal temperature. And so, I want to order drinks that are 下火, lowering my internal temperature. So basically, I kind of want to order something that's cool, refreshing. I have tea here today. I think I'm just going to go with the tea. And then finally, last and certainly not least, we have our sauces. Now the sauces are 酱, and I can go grab some of them myself, and you can see me choose whatever I want. It's a pretty open process. All right. So many. Oh man. Okay. Here we have 面条. Specifically, these are 火锅面. I'm supposed to put them in the pot to cook them. Okay? Here we have our 羊肉. Then down here you can see some of our other foods. We have 土豆. 土豆, potatoes. 这个是 pingu mushrooms. Then 冻豆腐. It's frozen bean curd. Frozen tofu. Here we have 鹌鹑蛋, little sparrow's eggs. And then everyone's favorite, the 招母花, 猪脑花, pig brain. And here we have our 鸡毛菜. 鸡毛菜, I don't think we have in the United States. It basically translates to chicken hair vegetable. So, I don't know, it kind of looks like spinach to me. Hopefully it tastes like that too. We'll see. Okay, I think this is all our food, so let's get started. Like 10 seconds and it's already gray and floppy, gelatinous. Oh. Okay. Let's go on a journey with me through this pig's brain. Practice them, that's the important part.